Self-discipline demanded. Self-discipline demanded. Brethren, we are running a race, a holy race, a righteous race, a race that you will stand before the Almighty Judge, who knows everything that you are doing. So the Lord is telling me, are you this morning? For you to run this race successfully, you must be self-disciplined. Self-discipline is something that nobody can do for you. You have the right to yourself. Even God cannot take the place of self-discipline in my life, in your life. Everything about you, when it comes to self-discipline, you have the right to it. You can be anointed but not disciplined. You can say, you can think you are holy, but without self-discipline, you will not go far. The Lord is telling you and I this morning, if we must run this race successfully, if we must win the battle over sin, over the power of the darkness, we must be self-disciplined. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Our lifetime on earth here determines our achievements. Either success or failure depend on you. The more you are disciplined, the more you will be succeeding. The more you have disciplined lifestyle, the more you succeed in life. And wisdom advise that we almost look at people who have made it before so that we know how to live our life. That's what the Bible told us in the book of Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. Discipline advises us to lay aside everything that will jeopardize our making heaven. Discipline advises us that we should learn to look at people who have made it before, so that we know how to do our own. The Bible told us in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 1, and it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord, if you will hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord. It takes discipline to connect to the mountain and know what you are doing on the mountain. It takes discipline for you to know that when I'm connected, that is not the time to be cooking. It takes discipline to know that when message is going on, I have to listen carefully so that I will not fall prey to the devil. He said, if you shall hearken diligently, not just hearken diligently. It takes discipline to hearken to the voice of the Lord diligently. Unto the voice of the Lord, to observe and to do all that he has commanded. The Lord will not force you to do his commandment. The Lord will not force you to do what I need to do. The Lord will not force you to pray. He will not force us to do anything. It takes discipline to know what to do. It takes your self-discipline to know what to do and when to do it. The Lord will only advise me and you. But we have the right to say, no, we're not going to do it, or we'll do it. Say that the Lord thy God will set thee on high, above all the nations of the earth. If you want to be above, you must learn to be disciplined. Discipline is demanded in this race. Many Christians today are not disciplined. Many Christians today, they are reprobate. They do things the way they want to do it. And they are saying, want to make heaven. It's not going to be so. The Bible told us in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 11. Rather, 1 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 11. And such were some of you, but you are washed, but you are sanctified, but you are justified in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. Verse 12. All things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. I will not be brought under the power of any. It is a decision. Apostle Paul disciplined himself. And his brother said, I will not be brought under the power of any. Because he disciplined himself. He knows what he can do and what he cannot do. Many of us don't even trust ourselves. We don't know what we can do and what we cannot do. We jump into sin and out as we like. Because we are not disciplined. You cannot tell when you will fall into anything. Anything can take you off track. Because you have not learned self-discipline. So therefore, self-discipline is demanded. Verse 13, meat for the belly for the meat. But God shall destroy both it and, them. Now the belly is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. Praise Master Jesus. Meat for the belly. Belly for the meat. You are able to control your appetite. You are able to control everything. When fast is coming, people are afraid already. How can I do this one now? Because you are glutton. You eat by second meal. You can't control how you eat. It's the food on the ground that controls you. Everything you see, you must eat it. You are baby in eating. You cannot go to the fridge and cross over. Once you get there, something must enter your mouth. And you're saying you are a Christian, you are not disciplined. You cannot stay till 12 before you eat. You are not disciplined. If you must survive in this race, you must learn to discipline yourself in everything. The way you look, the discipline. The way you eat, the discipline. Everything you are doing, you must subject everything to yourself. Apostle said, nothing can subject me to itself. I have disciplined myself to the extent that I am able to control everything around me. But many Christians today, they can't do so. They can't fast, they can't pray, they can't do nothing. Because things around them control them. And I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible told us in Hebrews 12, verse 11. Now, no chastising for present sin to be joyous, but grievous, nevertheless, afterward is ye the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. We should understand what the Lord is telling us, do this, don't do that. It is for our own good. Because we are not disciplined, we see them as if the Lord hates us. If you want to truly be a Christian, a real Christian, you must be disciplined. You must follow the principle of God. You must allow the Lord to chastise you. Don't do this, do that, don't do it. It's the rule of the game. is the rule of the game we or the race we are running now. But many people don't want to follow it. They want to be the master of themselves. They want to make sure whatever they see, they do it. I want to dress the way I love to dress. Nobody controls my dressing. The Bible cannot control my dressing. And we want to make heaven. It is not possible. So, the Christian life we are living today, because of the do's and don'ts in it, is not joyous. It's grievous. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You must not, it's not everything you want to do. When I say joyous, I mean, I know the joy I'm talking about. It's not everything that you see other people doing that you want to do. You must discipline your body. My body, you don't need this, you will not get it. My mouth, you don't need it. Let your flesh be crying. Before you will succeed, your flesh must cry. Your flesh must not rejoice. Your flesh must not rejoice over your spirit. If you want to succeed to the end, let your flesh cry all the time. The flesh must be crying for help while the spirit is rejoicing. But today, so many Christians, it's our flesh that is happy while the spirit is asking for help. I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible told us in Proverbs chapter 25, verse 28, he that has no rule over his own spirit is like a city that is broken down. He that cannot control himself, you have no power over your taste. You have no power over the way you speak, over things you do. Say you are like a city that is broken down. He said, you are like a city without wall. Anything can penetrate. Anything that comes, when anytime demons coming, he knows he will succeed and go. You are so open to whatever that comes, because you have no rule over yourself. You are pushed up and down. Yeah, you are like computer. They can computerize you anytime. It's not supposed to be so. The wind of doctrine can easily move you. Today is righteousness. Mm-hmm. Today is this. Mm-hmm. Anywhere they push you to, you are there. How would you make heaven that way? It's not possible for such people to make heaven, because at what time the Lord come, maybe before that time, Satan will take you off the track, because he knows how to deal with you. I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why Paul told us in the book of 1 Corinthians 9, verse 27, I keep under my body and bring it unto subjection. He bring everything unto subjection. He rules. When Apostle Paul was on earth, he rules. He command. Food, you have no part over me. Clothes, you have no part over me. Money cannot control me. Money cannot cajole me. So many people, men of God, because of money, you will not make heaven. Because you can be cajoled with them. Because of material things, you will not make heaven. Because they can easily fascinate you and you are gone. Apostle Paul said no to him. It was not so. You can never say this what I wish to catch him. If I give him this, it's finished. No. Give him money, he speaks the same way. Give him clothes, he speaks the same way. Food everywhere, he speaks the same way. There's no food, he speaks the same way. That was Apostle Paul. But today, many of us are not that way. Whenever Satan wants to pump you, he knows what to do. He press the button of money, you are finished. He press the button of food, you are finished. Because you are not self-disciplined. But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection. Women cannot easily use their body to entice me. Apostle Paul says so. I love our brother too. Brother Job. Say, I put my eyes into my into subjection. I make covenant with my eyes, discipline, that I will not look unto a maid. My body will not start misbehaving when I see them. Because I'll discipline my body to that extent. We should learn to discipline ourselves if we must make heaven. Else, when I preach, I come again, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, because of indiscipline, I myself should be a castaway. Because I was not able to discipline myself, I will not be a castaway. I pray, Lord, help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why he told us in Proverbs 15:32, he that refuses instruction despises his own soul. Because you are not displaying every instruction that comes your way, beg. I don't care. You don't care? No problem. When you get to that pit, you care, and nobody will care to instruct you again. It says, he that refuses instruction despises his own soul. But he that heareth reproof gathereth, getteth understanding. Discipline demands that we obey instruction. If you are self-disciplined, whenever the word of God comforts, especially the one that will take you to heaven, you hack into it and make do of it so that you will not fall into the pit of hell. Let us learn to discipline ourselves, especially the children of God who want to make heaven someday. Praise Master Jesus. He said to us, poverty and shame shall be to him that refuses instruction. Because of your indiscipline, every instruction is nothing before you. Say, poverty and shame shall be the clothes you are wearing. But he that regarded the proof shall be honored. Proverbs 13:18. Look around yourself now. You see what indiscipline has done to you. You see what you have caused yourself because of indiscipline. Mute your mic. That is when you will open your mic. Indiscipline. You are used to it already. It's in you. Obey simple instruction. No. You cannot obey it anymore because it has eat you deep. It's not like cancer. You have to pray for deliverance. You have to pray for it. Even when you don't want to do it, your hand will unmute it because it's not part of you. You try not to unmute it, but because that is your style now, you see yourself unmuting it. The spirit of indiscipline of eating such people up. They are distractors. Even when they don't want to distract, they see themselves distracting others because they have left it in the house. Their husband will say, hey, my wife, I am praying now, don't disturb me. That is when they will start making quacker, quacko, quacko, quacko in the kitchen. Hey, honey, maybe the wife say, honey, I am doing something now. That's when the husband will go to the fridge and start using small start to knock small start. Indiscipline. It starts from home. Charity begins at home. So even when they are not in the presence of people, they see themselves doing it unknown to them. So it's called for prayer. Pray for yourself. Every spirit of indiscipline is making me to fool myself outside, making me to abuse myself outside. Father, deliver me. Because indiscipline is a sin. Take somebody to hell. And I pray, the Lord help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Said Proverbs 29:15, the rod and reproof give wisdom. Give wisdom. But a child led to himself bringeth his mother to shame. This is the time to discipline our children now. Many of us, we are born again, but we were never disciplined when we were home. We never respect our parents. We were left loose. Now we are born again now. It's a problem to the Holy Spirit now. It's a problem to your guardian angels now. Your angel will tell you, hey, daughter of God, don't do that for where you go to a station, you should not go. Because you learned it when you were home. You never listen to your parents. You never listen to your brothers and sisters. You never listen to your advice. Now it's time for the Holy Ghost now. You are not also listening to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit command. Let us pray. That is where you'll be doing another thing. It's time for prayer, you'll be singing. Time for singing, you'll be praying. Time for prayer, you'll be laughing. Because you have learned it at home. It's not take you to hell now. You better pray for deliverance. So that you will not go to hell. And make sure you train your children now. Discipline them. So that they will not suffer what some of us are suffering today. In discipline. You are born again. Good. So many born again Christians are in hell. So many pastors are in hell. Because of indiscipline. Very, very, not even compulsive, mandatory for every child of God. Because any act of indiscipline is a sin to God. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Then to us in Proverbs chapter 20, verse 15. Proverbs 20, verse 13, rather. Love not sleep. Love not sleep. Some of us cannot control how we sleep. Sleep anytime. If we are disciplined, we should be able to subject our sleeping to ourselves. This time around, I will not sleep now. It's my time to pray. I should be praying now. He that loves sleep. He that loves sleep. We go into the pit of hell. Because when you will be sleeping in duty, on duty rather, Satan will come and pick you up from that place. Say, Lord, not sleep. Let that come to poverty. Everyone in hell, they are poor. They are in penury, poverty. They will never achieve anything again. Don't be a plus one in hell. Or this cell of eternity, you can say, hey, I need money now. Over there, you are poor. The person is poor forever. So, don't sleep too much. Don't sleep on duty. Love, don't sleep. Let thou come to poverty. Open the eyes, and thou shalt be satisfied with bread. I'm not saying you should rest, but don't use 18 hours out of 24 hours to sleep. Let the time that your eyes open be more than when you sleep. Every true Christian, every true warrior, if they sleep for 1 hour, 2 hours, they are okay. Don't sleep like the people of the world. Every good sleep should be 8 hours. 8 hours, what will you be seeing? Except God put you in revelation. What will a man be doing with 8 hours sleep? 6 hours sleep. The only way you can sleep that way, maybe 4 hours or 3 hours, after you have overworked, and God will tell you, my child, rest now. God will instruct you, my son, rest now. 3 hours. Maybe maximum 4 hours. 5, 6, 7, 8 hours. Christian, what will you be doing? Your hands must be working as a child of God. Your eyes must be working. You must be at work all the time. You know why? The demons do not sleep. The demons, they don't sleep. So don't sleep too much. So that they will not take the better part of you off. Subject your sleeping to yourself. If you truly want to make heaven, praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Then, if you want to truly make heaven, let every commandment of God be your portion. Proverbs 6, verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light. A reproof of instruction are the way of life. If you are disciplined, you see the commandment of God as a blessing. Whenever the true word of God is coming, you'll be happy. But because of indiscipline today, whenever somebody is speaking the word that will bless you, you'll be angry. You see a spirit waking up, getting angry of that man. Why is this man speaking this way? Why in such a way, you know that Satan have taken hold of you? How can a word that will take you to heaven come in your way? You are angry. Because you have learnt it before. Because nobody can tell you what to do. When you were there, your parents never control you. Now the word of God is trying to control you now, you are still angry. Because of the indiscipline lifestyle you learned when you were in the world. Today, you are exhibited now before the Almighty God. The word of God is coming that will train you, that will help you. You are angry of the man, of the woman that is preaching it. Indiscipline have caused that. So what do? Let us go and pray for deliverance. Father, deliver me from the spirit of indiscipline so that it will not take me to hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That's why before God time, Proverbs 16, verse 32. He that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. He that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. And he that ruleth his spirit than he that taketh a city. You can take the city today and break it down tomorrow. If you cannot control yourself, you can succeed today. Tomorrow, you are gone again because you cannot control yourself. So he said, he that is slow to anger, he that is able to control his anger, can control people, can control everything around him. But you gather today and scatter it tomorrow because of indiscipline. He that ruleth over his spirit is better than he that take city out of foolishness. Brethren, let us take charge over ourselves. Take charge over your tongue. Proverbs 16:32. Take charge over things you see. Take charge over the way you eat. Take charge over your eating. When you come to the mountain, take charge over yourself. Whenever they give instruction, little one, obey it. When that spirit starts to wake up, spirit, you better stay there now. Or get out of me. I must obey the word of the Lord. I pray the Lord give us understanding of this word. So that after all we have done, after all we think we are holy, prayer warrior, at the end, indiscipline, that will not be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The message you give says, self discipline demanded in this race. This is the word of advice for us this morning. May the Lord bless his word in our hearts in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. If you're out there, you're not born again, your case is different. Come out now and accept Christ as your Lord and personal Savior so that you will learn discipline from him. If a man is truly born again, you must be disciplined, because everything you will do, you'll be doing, will follow suit with Christ. Say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word this morning. I've been in darkness, but today I've decided to come out of darkness. Have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sins. Purge me from all unrighteousness. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you to the Lord Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. I am born again today. All things have passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for bringing your word my way. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
I pray with you. If you have confessed this confession, Father, I ask, O God, to strengthen your children. Father, without you in them, they can't do it. They will fall back. Holy Ghost, take charge over everything about them. Father, they have put their hands on the plow. May they never look back again in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let the world get behind them now and let the cross be before them. And I know at the end of it all, they will make it to heaven in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I pray, Lord, this word will not be used against me, nor against the hearer. Help us to be disciplined. Wherever we are still lacking discipline, Father, help every one of us, O God, to do something about it. Holy Ghost, help us. Deliver us from every spirit of indiscipline. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.